Mabuhay everyone! I am Adeline Ponsica, a first-year BS in Tourism Management student. Our lesson for this video is all about recreational problems using mathematics. Let us define first what is recreational mathematics. The term recreational math can refer to any game, puzzle, or activity that teaches math skills to help participants win. Recreational math goes beyond those games and into puzzles and brain teasers that require math to solve but are not the typical learn the formula and apply approach. Instead, using math to solve problems is part of the game itself. So based on the text here, recreational mathematics contains activities like games that math can be used. But sabi din dito, hindi natin siya ginagamitan ng memorization and application of formulas like the typical math solving na ginagawa natin, and we use mga difficult formulas to solve the specific problem. And of course, playing and learning recreational mathematics is a benefit to ourselves. The benefits of recreational math are many. So these are some benefits of recreational mathematics to us. First, motivation. Motivation especially to younger students. It is hard for them to understand math, but with the use of puzzle or game, students now have a direct reason to want to learn math, diba? Since kids nowadays mahilig sa games or online games, mamamotivate sila na through online games, pwede nilang matutunan yung math skills na pwede nilang gamitin sa pag-aaral nila. At pwedeng hindi sila lalaki ng perspective ay mahirap matutunan ang math. Another one is self-guiding. Once they understand how to do a puzzle, such as Sudoku, for example, students do not need to be supervised. They learn as they go on. So, masasanay sila na kumilos sa sarili nila and make some diskarte to solve the specific problem by using recreational mathematics. Next benefit, recreational mathematics can improve scores. So, games and puzzles improve student scores. That's true across all subjects, including math. Okay, since students who learn math through games have more success in remembering the lessons taught. They can also learn skills in solving grid puzzles like Magic Square that they will later use in solving math equations. Another and the last benefit is recreational math can improve cognitive skills. So, using recreational mathematics in solving problems can help our brain to improve the ability to think, read, learn, remember, and pay attention. So, here are the examples of math recreational games. First is Sudoku, Tower of Hanoi, Tangram, 2048, Ritmomachi, Magic Square, Monopoly, SOS, Cram, and Rubik's Cube. So, these are some. So, marami pang ibang example ng recreational math games. Now, let's try to execute and discuss three recreational games in mathematics. So, the first is Tangram. Or Tangram, okay? The Tangram is a dissection puzzle consisting of 7 flat shapes called tans, which are put together to form shapes. The objective of the puzzle is to form a specific shape given only in outline or silhouette using all 7 pieces which may not overlap. So, to execute this game, you have and we have to go to this link. So, let's go to this link to execute this game. So, this is the link. Yan. So, this is the 7 shapes. So, this is the 7 shapes called tan. So, ito. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So, 7 shapes na tinatawag nating tans. So, dito muna tayo sa pinaka-basic. Okay, so let's try this. Itong house na outline. So, sabi, sa objective ng game na to, dapat hindi mag-overlap sa isa't isa yung mga shapes. So, dapat mag-fit sila together sa outline na to or sa silhouette. Okay, so let's try. And, narorotate din yan if you want to and if you wish to, na-flip din siya. Yan, okay? So, let's try. Si square, ilagay dito sa taas. Yan, let's just fit it. Okay. Then, next, let's try this one. Pwede natin siyang i-rotate, ha? Ayan. Okay. And then, let's try this blue. Pwede natin siyang ilagay dito sa baba and pwede din sa taas pag pinlip natin siya. Ayan. And si pink, pwede natin siyang gawing ganyan. Mm-hmm. And then, let's try this dito. Yan. And si violet, let's try pag ganito natin siya. Or, yan. And dito siya. And ito, rotate natin siya pag ganyan. And yan. So, ganyan. Ganyan lang siya laruin. The easiest is to execute the basic first. So, isanay nyo muna yung mga sarili nyo to try the basic first bago kayo pumunta sa advanced. Okay? So, to execute, kung gusto nyo yung execute yung animals, may geometry din and may advanced kung magaling na kayo, just go to this link. Okay? Now, let's proceed to the next. So, the next game that we will try and discuss is 2048 or 2048. This can play through your mobile phones and desktop as website. Just click the link down below, okay? So, 2048 or 2048 is a single-player sliding tile puzzle video game written by Italian web developer Gabriele Cerulli and published on GitHub. The objective of the game is to slide number tiles on a grid to combine them to create a tile with the number 2048. However, one can continue to play the game after reaching the goal, creating tiles with larger numbers. So, this is a game played on 4x4 grid with numbered tiles. At each stage, you slide tiles in any of the four directions. It's either up, down, left, and right. If two tiles of the same number fall into one another, then they merge into a tile whose number is the sum of the tile's number. So, para mas maintindihan nyo, let's execute this game through this link, okay? Let's try. So, ito yung game na 2048. So, ganito yung itsura niya. So, let's try a new game. So, it's either i-move natin yung tile pa-left, pa-right, pa-up, or down. So, meron dito, guide, how to play. Use your arrow keys to move the tiles. When two tiles with the same number touch, they merge into one. So, yung pag nag-merge sila and nag-touch sila, yung same number, magiging tile nun or magiging ang kakalabasan nila is yung sum. Okay? Yung sum ng dalawang number na yon. So, let's try. Ayan. Itong 2 and 2. So, same sila ng number. Pag pinag-merge natin sila, ayan, magiging 4 because 2 plus 2 is 4. So, let's try another. Yan. So, let's try 4 and 4. Pag merge natin sila is equal to 8. So, ganyan. And then, 4 and 4. Again, 4 and 4, 8. Then, pwede na natin pag merge seat 8 and 8, magiging 16 because 8 plus 8 is 16. So, yan. It's up to you kung paano nyo siya gagalawin. Basta, ang objective ng game na to is makaabot kayo or makabuo kayo ng 2048 na tile. Okay? Yung pinakamataas na yun. It's up to you kung gusto nyo pang ituloy. Yan. 16 and 16, 32 and 32, 64. So, by this game, we can develop our math skills. Since dito, nag-a-add tayo ng same numbers at nadadagdagan siya. Diba? Lumalaki yung numbers niya. So, ayan. Pinakamalaking number na meron tayo is 64. Okay? So, paabutin lang natin siya ng mga 100. Ayan. It's either up, down, left, or right. Okay? Ayan. Pag-merge natin ang same numbers. 64. Yan. Meron na tayong 128. Aha. Ganyan lang siya. Hanggang sa makakuha kayo ng, ayan, napuno na, ng 2048 na tile. I mean, yung tile na isa, 2048 dapat. So, yan, game over na tayo kasi napuno na natin yung 4x4 na grid. So, if you want to execute, just go to this link kung gusto nyo siyang matry and then, yan. Next is the magic square. In recreational mathematics, a square array of numbers, usually positive integers, is called a magic square if the sums of the numbers in each row, each column, and both main diagonals are the same, okay? But before we try to execute or play this game, I will discuss first the steps to properly play this game, okay? So, the first step, list the numbers in order from least to greatest on a sheet of paper. Second step, add all 9 of the numbers on your list up to get the total. Then, divide the total from step 2 by 3. Go back to your list of numbers and the numbers in very middle of that list will be placed in the center of the magic square. And then for the fifth step, X, okay, yan, may X tayo dito. X represents the number in the center square. Then, place the number X plus 3 in the upper right-hand square. Then place the number X plus 1 in the upper left-hand square. Then, place the number X minus 3 naman in the lower right-hand square. Then, place the number X minus 1, the last one, in the lower upper left-hand square. And for the last step, fill the remaining squares keeping in mind the magic number. So, para mas maintindihan nyo, let's execute. Okay, so by going to this link, ma-execute natin siya at mapapakita ko sa inyo ng mas maliwanag para mas maintindihan. So, ito siya. Ayan. Level 1 muna tayo. Magsimula muna tayo sa pinakamadali, okay? So, ang sabi, so, susundan natin yung steps na diniscuss ko kanina. So, first step, list the numbers in order from least to greatest on a sheet of paper. Pero dito na lang natin siya i-organize or i-arrange from least daw to greatest. So, pinakamababa, pataas tayo. Nakamababa natin is si 1, then sumunod si 2, si 3, Ayan, si 3, si 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So, ayan. Ngayong naka-arrange na sila from least to greatest, let's have the second step. Add all 9 numbers on your list up to get the total. So, ia-add daw natin silang lahat. So, dito sa ating example, ia-add natin 1 plus 2 is 3. Okay? Plus 3 is 6. Plus 4 is 10. Plus 5 is 15. Plus 6, 21. Plus 7, 28. Plus 8, 36. Plus 9, 45. So, yung total nilang lahat is 45. So, once we get the total of the 9 numbers, we are going to divide the total by 3. So, sabi kasi sa step 3, divide the total from step 2 by 3. So, 45 divided by 3 is 15. So, ngayon, yung 15 na yun yung ating magic number. So, tandaan nyo yung magic number natin, ha? 15 ang ating magic number. So, dapat all the numbers in all rows, columns, and diagonals the numbers from all the rows, columns, and diagonals, pag pinagsama-sama sila, pag inad sila, dapat ang magiging sum nila is 15. Kasi yun yung ating magic number. Okay, so let's try now. So, sabi, go back to our list. So, ito yung list natin, ha? So, it is very essential to list it in order from least to greatest. So, para makuha natin si middle, yung nasa middle natin, yung lalagay natin dito. Titignan natin kung ano ang median nito. Kung nasan ang middle dito. So, ang middle is si 5. Okay? Since 9 sila, ang middle natin is si 5. Then, next step, x represents the number in the center, square. So, ang x natin dito is si 5. Tandaan nyo yan, ha? Ang x natin is si 5. Then, place the number x plus 3 in the upper right hand. So, this is the upper right hand. This is the upper right hand square. So, x plus 3. Ang x natin is 5 plus 3, 8. Yes, very good. 8. Why 8? Because x plus 3 dito sa upper right hand. So, ang x natin is si 5 and then plus 3 is equal to 8. Okay, next. Place the number x plus 1 in upper left hand square. So, this is the upper left hand square. X plus 1 naman daw dito. Ang ating x is 5. Again, x is 5 plus 1, 6. Okay. Diyan si 6. Now, let's move on to the next. Place the number x minus 3 naman. X minus 3 sa lower right-hand square. So, this is the lower right-hand square. So, x minus 3. 5 minus 3. Ibig sabihin, 5 minus 3 kasi x natin is 5. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Yes, that's very good. It's 2. And then, place the number x minus 1 in the lower upper left hand square. Yan, upper left hand square. So, this is the upper left hand square. X minus 1. X minus 1 natin is 5, ibig sabihin 5 minus 1. So, 4 ang sagot. Okay? Yan. Now, ito na lang yung mga natitirang numbers. So, ang gagawin na lang natin is if we fill in na lang natin yung mga remaining square. So, 4 na lang yung kulang. Ang gagawin na lang natin is tandaan na natin or isaisip na natin si magic squares. Si magic number. So, si magic number natin is 15. So, let's start at this row, okay? At this row muna kayo mag-focus. So, gagawin nating technique, 6 plus 8. So, papag-plusin muna natin itong dalawang to. 6 plus 8 is 14. So, ilan na lang para maging 15 siya at makuha yung magic number natin? Isa na lang, ba? Diba? So, dito natin ilalagay si 1. Okay? So, dito medyo mahirap-hirap siguro para sa iba. So, tatry muna natin pa ganito. Pa ganito muna tayo. Pa column muna tayo. So, let's try 6 plus 2. Since ito pa lang yung available para ma-fill in natin to, 6 plus 2 is equal to 8. So, ilan na lang para maging 15? 7 na lang. Yes, very good. 7 na lang. Then, dito naman tayo sa next. Pa-column ulit tayo. 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. So, ilan na lang para maging 15? Yes, 3. 3 na lang. So, dito si 3. And of course, dito na si 9. Okay? Magkabalik-baliktad man yan, basta same yung magic numbers nila, dapat pag pinag-plus-plus sila, ang sum nila is yung magic number natin kanina. So, paano ulit kinuha si magic number? Yung sum ng lahat ng numbers, i-divide natin sa 3. Okay? So, let's check it. So, tama tayo. Congratulations, yehey. Tama ang ating pagkaka-arrange. Kasi, 6 plus 1 plus 8 is 15, which is our magic number. 7 plus 5 plus 3 is 15. 2 plus 9 plus 4 is 15. So, pinagsum natin siya by row, nakuha natin si magic number ng tama. By column, 6 plus 7 plus 2 is 15. 1 plus 5 plus 9 is 15. 8 plus 3 plus 4 is also 15. Tama tayo by row. Pag ganito naman tayo, yan, pa-x tayo. 8 plus 5 plus 2 is 15. 6 plus 5 plus 4 is also 15, which is our magic number. So, ganun lang yung magic square. You just have to remember the magic number so that you can arrange it properly. Of course, you have to remember these 8 easy steps, okay? Thank you for watching my educational video. I hope you've learned something. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.